cream cone around my neck. Or the fact that I have a good ice cream cone around my neck. That's what I like. This is my stuff. And as long as I'm being a good person, a decent person, I'm not going around saying hurtful things to people just because that's what I'm thinking. I'm not going around
call me Phil of the future or something because I just went to the past.
I'm a good person. I'm not doing anybody any harm. I'm not hurting anybody's feelings by being this.
And I went to the future also, and I also went there a couple times. So last year I went to 2004, it doesn't matter how it looks, which was about 10 years ago, maybe. It's about 13, 14, 18 years.
I demand respect.
I'm not exactly sure, but we could also look that up in an encyclopedia.
You have your own thoughts and opinions.
Anyway, I do have some wares to sell, but I'm not selling anything. So I'm just going
to
show you some shit, probably, because, you know, you guys probably aren't doing much today. It's a Friday, and I can't get a job, so I'm here doing this, waiting for my court date and all that shit. So let's roll on.
People should just keep their negative thoughts to themselves.
By the way, I drove without a license,
thoughts,
so I'm in big fucking
blurt
trouble.
Out. Just don't do that, okay? And two, think about what you're going to say and what you're going to do.
I mean, I don't really like driving because I'm horrible at it.
Some people are just mean because that's what they like to do. Like, whatever. I wish I could just take those people who are mean and ignorant.
Give me a car.
And
rude, I wrecked
and just, like,
three cars.
On purpose. I wish I could take them and just, like, push them away into, like, a room, like, lock them in there or something. They can, like, be mean to each other.
Start driving as a kid,
all the people
you're
gonna
get in a lot of problems.
Want to live their lives and do their thing.
You're doing stupid shit.
And people are just like,
you know, that's what
good people and don't try to be hurtful. We could all stay here and be happy in our own like little glittery environment.
Picture me. This is my old driver's license.
And I know I'm definitely not the only person who deals with this, but it doesn't matter how we look.
Just kidding.
Be respectful and keep your negative shit to yourself. That's all.
Time traveling and whatnot.
That's it.
It was a great time. We had a blast.
I'm a good person, and I make the effort to be a good person.
Actually,
and not
quite wonderful.
Shout
quite
all
wonderful,
the things
quite
that people
wonderful.
And
so
people are on receipt, whatever
Vain
you
Magazine.
Guys do. Like, I make an effort to be a good person,
put the link
and
up so
I deserve
can,
the same respect back.
Let's just get the link here. Let's go and get the link here. Let's get the link. Me and the link. Dumbass fucking post or whatever. Let's see if there's some oh yeah, isn't there like a rap song called Roseanne Barr? That's gonna happen like 50 times. Damn. So I can't be watching that at the same time. That's gonna get me in big trouble. Yeah, that's gonna get me in some trouble there. That's gonna get me in some fucking trouble right there. So, hey, if you just entered, I'm guessing nobody did because nobody gives a shit. We're going to be reading about varicose veins today. Varicose veins, what's in the genes from Vain Magazine. Let's see what, this is for winter, 2017. I got this like 6 months ago, but, you know, we can read it in winter 2017. It's winter by now. So we have a couple experts here. Steve Elias, MD, FACS, FACPH. He's the director of Centers for Vein Disease at Inglewood Hospital and Medical Center, New Jersey and Mount Sinai Hospital, New York. So, I don't know about this ad, but let's take it out. So it says here, her legs aren't the only place the results will show. You may also see it in her expression. So this is like an example of good adlature. This is what good adlature does to a goodly good. And if we remember from my license, you know, I look like an idiot. So, you know, that somehow that correlates. And I'd like to say that it does. And you can also say that it does, too, because I'm not, and also. So, do you suffer from FOMO? And we can look up what fear FOMO is, because I'm trying to help you guys here by reading Vain Magazine. You can only get this if you're a doctor, so I do have the hookup. So we can arrange some surgery, but I can't do that for you. You need to go to the hospital. I can just tell you which hospitals are nice and good, because I can ask a professional and an expert. And if we're not being experts here, then I'm not the smart guy that I could have been also, you know? I mean, there were some moments where I honestly felt like I could have, and the truth and the forgiveness, but then we'll forget sometimes, but that's okay, because we do know. And when I read Alex Jones' post on Twitter, I was just, and then it also was, there was something truth to it, and I couldn't, the Alex Jones truth has come out, obviously. Like, obviously the Alex Jones, Alex Jones, and then remember that Alex Jones also knew about the psychedelic vampires from Play Clacks. And then we remember that we can go and we don't have to remember. So, we can also be in the dark here. So, I'm in the dark. This is the darkness. This way. This shit is not that. This right here. This is dark. So we're gonna feel around in the dark here. We're gonna see what's up. It's cool. So I'm gonna go a little slightly this way. What's going on here? Nothing. So I'm gonna leave it about here. Hold on. Okay, well, I'm gonna leave it here, because obviously this is probably a better idea anyway, bro. Like for real, bro. Have you heard the new Little Pump? Like for real, like bro, did like fucking like Little Peep died, bro? Did you know? Like who the fuck is Little Peep? But hey, like did you know? Like bro, I called him a faggot once, and I feel so bad. Like, I'm such an asshole. Like every time that I've said something mean to somebody, I actually do need to forgive a lot of people, because I'm an asshole, like, 100% of the time, I swear. Oh, look, we found it. You know what? That's the truth. See, when you forgive things, mystical things happen. Good things happen. So, if you're not doing anything with your life, then what the fuck are you doing with your life? Because if you're doing something with your life, but also at the same time not doing something with your life, then you're actually wasting your fucking life. You know, if hell is cold and it's going to be on fire, that means that you have to go through both ice and fire, and then maybe some water death in between that. I'm not really down to die 1,000 times, so yeah, it's cool if you want to do that. Like, I understand the romanticism, like, I do understand that, and I'll show you I do, because I have a unibrow and I'm, you know, ugly, so, like, I understand romanticism, like, bruh, I do. Like, I really do. Like, really, dude. So, we're gonna move this unicorn to the right, because everything's okay now. We're not gonna say anything mean about people, because obviously I've done a lot of that, because I'm a jerk. And that's okay, because, you know, everybody can be forgiven, even if nobody forgives me. But, you know, a lot of people do, so I'm kind of happy about it. There's my, look, we also found, my life. My life here. This is my godmother. One of my godmothers. I have a lot of them. Yeah, she, you know, this is Tina Krause. She was in a lot of Gary Whitman movies. Gary Whitman's one of my favorite directors. Peace to Gary Whitman in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. If we don't, start appreciating people, they're gonna fall to hell, and they're gonna die. Because, you see, if, hell is more like, being addicted to drugs. because that's the hardest part about life, is that being addicted to drugs sucks. And it also means that you're not real. You're really just not real. It's very hard to feel real when you're addicted to drugs. And I went through a lot of that, and I didn't feel real, and I definitely wanted to die. Like, there was many times, and then everything that I, that all the suffering that, after that, basically, it sucks. Sucks ass. Asshole. Junkie jury. Not good. Not fun. Not good at all. You know, I'm sitting here eating Burger King, not right now, but in the past tense. Right now, I'm actually rocking with some Happy Holidays. Penguins and all that. You know, penguins are amazing creatures. Let's look up some facts about penguins. Hold on, I'll read you up some facts. We'll get some facts about penguins, hold on. And I'll, you know what, I'll explain the track today. I'll explain whatever. You know, yeah, keep it real, like Milkbone. We'll put on some Milkbone, and I'll read about penguins. Put on some Milkbone. Oh, hold up. I got Flu Buddy in here. This is how we're doing it. I love The Stand. That's my favorite movie. I can't post it in soft mod because I don't have... any goodliness? Hold on. I'm gonna do a quick intermission. And then I'll play a game, turn on some music, and then do whatever. But I'm just gonna play some music right now. Okay, I'm gonna save them, whatever. Whatever. I don't think that's gonna work. That's okay. I'll just play some music off my computer. Let's see what's up. Oh shit, I have to do that. Hold on. Gotta finish this. We're rockin' rollin'. We're all gonna have a good time. If you don't like your life, you'll be fine. Don't worry, cause everything's okay. If you don't wanna be that way, hey, you're cool, you're fun, everyone's lame, but you're cool. Okay, so we're gonna put a couple more images in here just to keep everybody entertained while I go upstairs. I need some water, like, I don't feel good. Some horses, you know, whatever. Yeah, these are good changes. I don't give a shit. Just do it. There. Put that here. Then we can, put a little more shit in here. Let's see. Okay. There we go. We can have that. It's a little information for people. I like that. Information's good. Information's about as good as it gets. Because you don't get much more information than information's sake. Because if you don't have information, then what do you have? Then you have... What? Like, you're gonna be an asshole to somebody because of their skin or their fucking preferences? I mean, yeah, like, I mean, there's very much enticing the, also, the fascism is sometimes enticing to people, but that's not very, you have to, like, disregard every single person in your life, and do you really do that? I don't think so. I think you just listen to hard metal, and they're like, whoa, I want to be, like, a hard ass now, and I want to go beat up people because, like, that'll get me chicks and stuff. But I don't think that really gets you chicks. I think that actually probably gets you beat up by a chick, because a lot of these chicks aren't playing you now. Because, you know, have you seen Princess Nokia go beat that chick? I don't know what you could call it. But she beat up that thing they call a boy at the show, I mean, he's not a transgender, it's a guy, but, you know, we call those it's, you know what I mean? You know, she did that, and that's, you know, that's cool, whatever. I don't think there's anything such as, like, subjective truth. I think maybe subjective truth to yourself, but saying that you believe in some, you're like, oh, this is my truth. Like, there is no my truth. That's just a fucking lie that you're telling yourself. There's no truth. Like, I love Princess Nokia. I love them. But I think that was a dumb statement. Like, Vice did her dirty on that shit. They made her look kind of dumb. And I don't like when good artists look dumb. I just thought that was a really stupid statement. My truth. Like, bro, there's truth out there. You need to go look for it. You need to go, like, look in a lot of books to find truth. You can't just, like, make up some shit. Like, that's, like, what are you doing? Are you misleading people? Do you want people to die or something? Like, I just don't get that. I don't understand what a subjective truth is. Well, this is the truth that I would choose to believe. Like, no, you can't. I mean, yeah, you can do that when you're, like, a kid. Because, hell yeah, like, imaginary friends and shit. But when you're an adult and it gets down to the time when, like, we're all, like, fucking 20 to 26... we need to go work and shit. Like, I can't work right now because I have a case and I drove without a license. So, you know, if you do that, you get fucked over. You do get fucked over. You really do get fucked over, and it sucks. And there is no, there's no escaping it. I can't go and say, yo, I don't want to pay $1,000 to get a license. And they'll say, well, fuck you, because, you know, we kind of have a fascist system here. If you haven't noticed, if you walk down in Chicago, there's a lot of fascists down there. And there's no, I like studying fascism. I like studying all kinds of political theories. But, you know, just the way that that book Leviathan has affected our culture so much, it's like they had never even read this book. Jacob Burckhardt's rendition of, or I guess it was a translation or something. It must have been written in Latin if it was Machiavelli. All right, I'll be right back. Some loud ass lion shit. How many of y'all's dads are fucking lions? Start like roaring every time they want to talk. They're like, brrr. I don't know. I guess I didn't leave in on any music. Just gotta export this cover real quick. I'll put on something new. I'll drop some new shit. Not like anyone cares. Dude, I love that new drop. Bang, bang, boy. Chicago shit. You from Chicago? Yeah, I eat Euros and shit. Yep. That's us. We eat the Euros. Yo, I thought you were in California. Nope. That didn't work out for me. I was like, my brain is dead. Why do I do this? I know it's 1400, but I always make these images 777. Like, why does it matter? I don't know, but 1400. Because fuck 12, I guess? Fuck 12. Fuck 12, and then 13 must be a bridge. And if 13's a bridge, then 14 must be redemption. Maybe, I don't know. Who am I kidding? I'm a dork. Do I have all that flu buddy shit? Hell yeah, I got that flu buddy shit. Alright, put this flu buddy on. Hold up. Flu buddy. Flu, buddy. Shit. Now we're getting down here. It's real flu buddy hours. Damn, I'm ugly. Like a damn troll, boy. I'm about to be. I'm someone just a fucking troll. Nah, it's not true. It's not true.
We're all just fucking trolls. We look stupid. We look fucking stupid.
Ow, shit. Yeah, I'm definitely dying. Yeah, I'm in big trouble here, folks. No, that's not what I wanted. That's not what I asked for. It's definitely not what I asked for. It's not what I asked for. Hey, that's not what I asked for, mate. Bro. Bruh. It's not what I asked for. Brody, Brody, Brody. Tex-Mex? The Tex-Mex that time forgot. I guess I'm that. Where my space cowboys at? No one, because nobody watches.
The Tex-Mex that time forgot. The Tex-Mex. Checks mix
for your mind. Checks mix. Oh, look at all these Chex Mix tchotchkes. Toin, check. 1, 2, 3, Chex Mix tchotchkes. Check, Chex Mix. Chex Mix tchotchkes. Tchotchke, Tchaikovsky, chop. He's got the Chex Mix in the bag. He's got the Chex Mix. Chex Mix. Is there any fucking Chex Mix commercials? Hold the phone. Chex Mix. How much fucking data I have? None. 'Cause I'm stupid as fuck. And I'm dumb as long. I'm stupid as fuck. I'm dumb as a curse. These bitches know what is up. Alright, I'm gonna leave this on. Y'all can just sit here and just like chill with my shit. I'm gonna teach you about how to pray. I'm also gonna teach you about Western civilization. Good stuff, the bad stuff, we'll do Eastern Civilization sometime later. Ah! Family of mercy. Notre Dame is come to Boscan, Billikaban. Usti bas like Gima, de inside Bullikan and some munchies are my two bad feet. I was happy day, punching ding. Way say they don't buy. I'm coming out the water. It's the water. The medieval times has come. The water is mine. Oh, it feels so good on my lung lining. It feels so good on my lung lining. It feels so fucking good on my lung lining. Gross. It's my rendition of experimental film. All right, we're back again. Fatty Bakes. Big Nash. Shouts out to John. It's good, dude. It's good. It's good. It's good, buddy. Alright, I'll play a game. Fuck it. Let's do it. What game? I'm gonna keep it on Vampire Hunter D because I don't know anything. I'm kind of dumb. But I'm also kind of smart. I got a couple sharp cookies. I've got a couple brain cells. I mean, if you don't have a couple brain cells, you might as well have none.
so important. There are some in poor. Mom, yum, yeah. Oh, la Saint Joss, the little mean, or the Katsonia Moors, the little me chambaleka. Lee, mole sanessa. Me just say. Ah, the tasty freeze is tasty in the morning, but taste in the night. Taste in the night by Cymbaloo Gobbledoo. Cymbaloo Gobbledoo was an artist in 1933, and he was making Fats Domino music for the ages. He turned electronic music into So, we can also go to the secondary terrestrial inexplicable porting Mighty Gong Gile. Also, and I do remember. Yes. Okay, so we can also go to Machiavelli and we will turn on some nice soothing music because the music that we do listen to is important to what we do here. Because if it is not about the positivity, people, then it is about the negativity or the nihilism. Because if we are engulfed in nihilism, then we are basically killing ourselves because that's a bunch of bullshit. Okay? I own this movie, okay? I've seen the movie, alright? I've seen the movie, guys. It's French movie. It's our Greg Kokoroki and Roseanne Barr. That's it. That's all it is. It's two parts Roseanne runs into Garby. That's all it is. It's fine. So this is nowhere. You can watch this movie, and if you become a nihilist, you probably shouldn't watch movies again. Because movies make people nihilist if they don't watch them. Because half the time, you're on your phone like this. I'm on my big iPhone. I'm on the biggest iPhone ever. And this iPhone also does pizza editing and pizza dough. Pizza editing is my favorite editing software. When I edit the pizza, I can also edit my life. So, what I'll do here is, I'll watch this movie. Let's see. Island of Dr. Moreau. I'm not gonna watch it the whole time, but I'm gonna say things when the music gets louder. The music is super loud! Oh my goodness! There's stuff going on in this movie that I don't understand. Ha 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 ha! And then we talk about the Uagawas. Uagawas. We could talk about Uagawas because that's what I'm describing right now. Uagawas are people that do not want to engage in society. They don't like other people and they don't give a fuck. They can make music, they can make art, but it's always going to be negative. Because their negativity wants, they want their cup to fill over with the negativity so they can look super cool! I want to be a super cool rapper someday and tell everybody to kill themselves! I don't know. Uagawas are a bunch of fucking idiots. I'm on my big iPhone. Yo, Juicy J, sign me now. I'm a real OG 666 fan, bro. 666 is like the bomber dumber. And that's actually not insane because you know it's true. So if anyone gets mad at that, know that they're mad at the truth. That's the truth. That's the truth, boy. And they'll say, he's crazy, but no, I've always been this way, I just never talked. I won't talk to people because I don't know how to talk to people. That's why I'm talking to myself. So we're going to turn on some music. Little Xan Exposed. Okay. Little Xan Exposed. And of course, that pedophile No Jumper is doing it, so... You know he likes that bullshit, so let's send him blessings. But also be aware that his business, he doesn't do enough for people. He really doesn't, because he's doing drugs himself. If he wasn't doing drugs himself, he would be full on using his platform to help people, but no, he likes money. And that's okay. We shouldn't shame people that like money. I just think that stupid decisions should be brought to light. Why not? It's kind of dumb when we're sitting around thinking that every single person in the world is just hunky-dory. Yeah, 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 he just killed somebody, but he's got a good rap song. He has a really good rap profile. A really good rap song has to have somebody dead on the other end. Do you live in Chicago, motherfucker? I don't think you do. I think you live in fucking Seattle. I think you live all over the world where there's suburbs. I live in the suburbs too, but there's people that fucking die out here because of heroin. Heroin kills people in the suburbs, while guns kill people in the city. And it's not really guns that kill people, it's the people behind the guns. Because guns, all honestly, haven't really changed. Because if they had changed, then... Well, we would have laser guns by now, and you could just obliterate me through the fucking computer, but you can't. So, what we need to know is that we need to change, obviously, because a bunch of fucking idiots running around saying, "Oh, dude, the 666, my dick, bitch, ooh, boy, I'm so fucking hot right now, I'm on right now, I'm up right now, no, you're fucking down right now, now get the fuck out." Just sit in your fucking chair and sit there. Oh, my pain is so beautiful. My romance. I love romance. Romance is so good. Romance. I love romantic sadness, and it's super duper de duper good. And that's my little rant about people that only put out negative stuff. And they just love, you know, co-opting goth culture, like, oh yeah, goth is like a bunch of people that love to throw their lives away and they never had anything to begin with. I don't know what that is, but I think that's Satanism. And not really much hate for Antoine LaVey. I think I have some respect for him for laying it out very... As my friend Alex said, very clear. Very clear. Anton LaVey is very... I mean, if you are an atheist, that's kind of the Bible for you. Because if you don't believe in God, then you can just do whatever the fuck you want, and there's no repercussions. You don't believe in karma. If you believe in karma, then you have to believe in some kind of connection between humans. And if you don't believe in the connection between humans, then is your life non-entity, or are you nothing? So if you're nothing, then you're nothing. Then obviously, then what does anything matter? That's why I said, if I could post this movie in SoftMod, I would, but I can't. The only thing I can post is, I can post something. I'll post it later. But, as I was saying, rap music is at a point where most of it is shit. And it's not just the above-ground artists, it's also the underground artists. I mean, most of them are chasing after some shit that's just like, okay, yeah, I want to be a demon guy. I love demons. I'm a demon. I'm not an angel. I'm a demon. And then half the time they want to say, I'm an angel. I'm a fallen angel. I'm a Nephilim Adipitus. I'm a Nephilim. I read the Book of Enoch, and now I can speak Enochian.
Whoa, buddy. No, and then this is just real talk, honestly. Like, I love people's music. Like, even if it has a dumbass message, I'll listen to it. I like most people's music. If you put something out, that means that you're doing something other than killing yourself, and that's what I'd like people to do. And most of the time, it's the drugs that get in the way of the music. And the music can never get anywhere because you need the industry to provide you the drugs. You need either the industry or to sell drugs to do that. So drugs just fuck up the music. I know it romanticizes it, bro, but we do not live in the romantic era. That shit's over, and all those people died of drug overdoses, and they killed themselves. Mary Shelley? She's dead because she killed herself. So, I'm going to read a prayer. I don't care what you say. I'm going to do it. Because I don't, what?
nobody likes me anyway, so I'm just gonna fucking do it. I'm gonna put on some choreo, whatever. Some Orthodox hymns. And I hope you know, I love each and every single one of you. I'm gonna turn off my lights and all that. There's no hatred to any group or people, whether it be a rap group, certain group, religious group, or whatnot. The whole point of this whole group soft mod is to bring all kinds of spiritual people together for understanding. And also to promote nonviolence, because violence obviously has not worked. There is no revolution. It's just a lie. That's the fucking problem, is that it's a lie. Every revolution has been a concealed lie. I'm not kidding. Every revolution has been a lie. There's nothing in your life that you cannot do. There's nothing in your body you cannot heal. Your life is more precious than anything on this entire universe. Okay? You could have the entire universe. You could have the entire universe, but you don't want it. If you don't want it, then you don't get it.
Слава Отцу і Сину і Святому Духу, нині і присно, і во веки веков. Амінь.
And this is not a cult either. I don't give a shit what anybody says. I hate cults. My mom showed me enough cults to know that cults are just the most disturbing things in the universe, because you give people hope and then you throw it away in the garbage and destroy their lives. Only sadists do that. And I do have some sadist tendencies, but I'm trying to be extremely truthful to pretty much the whole group so that you know this is not a fucking cult. Okay, you could speak in 1,000 romantic languages. I could say 1,000 words to get people to believe something, but it's not worth it if you don't know the heart behind it.
O Lord Jesus, O God, forgive us our iniquities.
Through the intercessions of thy most pure mother, save the suffering Russian people from the yoke of godless authority. Amen. Pray unto God for me, O Holy God, pleaser, for I fervently flee unto thee, speedy helper and near intercession for my soul. O Theokotos, and Virgin, rejoice, Mary, full of grace. The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb. For thou hast borne the Savior of our souls.
Восприят Ізраїля отрока свого, помянути милости, Якоже глагола к отцям нашим Аврааму
and bless thy inheritance. Grant thou unto Orthodox Christians victory over enemies, and by the power of thy cross do thou preserve the commonwealth.
In
the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This message brought to you by Renee O'Connor.
State as a work of art in Civilizations of the Renaissance by Nicolai. Oh no, this is Jason Burkhardt. Jason Burkhardt's Civilization of the Renaissance in Italy. The papacies and dominions of the Church are creations of an also peculiar kind that we have hitherto. In determining the general characteristics of Italian states, referred to them only occasionally. The deliberate choice of an adaption of political expedients which gives so great an intense to the other states is what we find least of all in Rome. Since here the spiritual power could constantly conceal or supply the defects of the temporal. And what fiery trials did this state undergo in the 14th and beginning of the 15th century, when the papacy was led captive to Avignon? All at first was thrown into confusion, but the Pope had money, troops, and a great statesman and general. The Spaniard Albarranos, who again brought the ecclesiastical state into complete subjection. The danger of a final dissolution was still greater at the time of the schism, when neither the Roman nor the French Pope was rich enough to reconquer the newly lost state. But this was done under Martin V, after the unity of the Church was restored, and done again under Eugenius IV, when the same danger was renewed. But the ecclesiastical state was and remained a thorough anomaly among the powers of Italy. In and near Rome itself, the papacy was defied by the great families of Colonna, Orsini, Sabelli, Anguillara, in Umbria, in the Marches, and in Romagna. The civic republics had almost ceased to exist. For those in devotion to the papacy had showed so little gratitude, their place had been taken by a crowd of princely dynasties, great or small, whose loyalty and obedience signified little. As self-defended powers, standing on their own merits, they have an interest of their own, and from this point of view, the most important of them had already been discussed. Amen.
And then we're going to read about the ghosts. And then hopefully you guys have some discussion about this. Click start and then find, then files or folders. To find all files, dialog box opens. If you want to search by file and folder name, click the name and the location tab, then type in all part of or the of and of the file, folder, or name in the name text box. If you type the name, find will list all the files of folders of that name. If you part the part of the name, fill out little file site and names you can type.
Okay. Encyclopedia of Ghosts.
Oh look, it's a letter from my dad when I graduated school. So I'll read that to you because, you know, sentimental, heartbreaking, everything is my fault. I'm so very proud of you for doing so well in school this year and getting high honors. I love you so much, Dad. A nice letter from the past. I'll read it again. May 26, 2006. James, congratulations on reaching your star. I'm so very proud of you for doing so well in school this year and getting high honors. I love you so much, Dad. So, you know, dad's love out here. Sometimes, if you have a dad, hold on to him, bro, because a lot of people don't, and they're sad about it, and it sucks. It's literally like kind of one of the worst things that could happen to you is not having a dad. Okay, so we're gonna read about what haunted. I can't check the chat because I don't know how to do anything. We're gonna read about the bloody ghost. Actually, the Borley Reactory, we'll do that next time. Borley Reactory next time. The bloody ghost. Bloody Ghost. St. James Palace in London was built by Henry the Eighth for his queen Anne Boleyn on the site for former leper hospital. But it is not the ghost of the king or his most tragic queen of the poor and despised lepers that haunt that site. The prominent and ghastly ghost of St. James Palace is the specter of a small man with his throat cut and his mouth hanging open. He sits propped up in a bed against the wall in the haunted room, and the entire scene is drenched in blood! The specter has its origins in a sensational incident that took place on May 31st, 1810. The Duke of Cumberland, George III's dreadful and debauched son, had returned to St. James late one evening. The servants had heard the sounds of fight, fight, flight, fight, flight, fight, coming from the Duke's bedroom. Woo! But noises were not uncommon, and they were ignored. The Duke had two valets, you and Salis. When the noise had quieted down, the Duke called for you, who found his master covered in blood, but otherwise quite cool and composed. Yeah, man, the future's looking so dumb, I might as well wear dumbass shades. The prisoner of Azkaban. Now I must read with my reading glasses so I can get bad vision and have to wear glasses. That's what I'm doing. I'm smart. I'm a smarty. He
he said that he had been attacked but managed to fight the attackers off. And he had been attacked but had managed to fight the attackers off and had been wounded in the process. The physician was sent off for it and found that Duke had Hadouken and Huga do Hadouken and then had also only slightly wounded on his sword hand. The Duke then called you and asked for him to find Salus. Salus was in his room, sitting up so perfectly straight in bed. There was a deep gash in his throat, and so deep that his head had nearly been severed. And blood-covered razor was found across the room. In inquest, the Duke insisted that Salus distracted to murder, insisted to murder him, and then committed to the suicidal. And then the truth that appears to have been that the Duke had an affair with Salus's daughter, who then and then committed the suicide in order to commit to Salus. The Duke cut off the man's throat with his own sword, then arranged things to look like it's a suicide, and then the Duke was never promising, and the Duke of the Don was always duking it and rocking the dookity dee dee. And then what brought the trial, but as the news of what happened, the Duke, who had never been Duke, he was popular, but he was not popular ever, and that's also what that book says. And it was openly booed on the streets and on the stable to show his face. He was not able to show his face in London. So we can also check out the Tower of London. So tomorrow I'll do Borley Reactory and Tower of London. And then we'll read a Machiavelli, one of the discourses, and then another prayer. That's how I'll do things on this live. I'll play games later. This is just an introduction to the channel. I'll upload this. Thank you, guys. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Go in love. Don't kill anybody unless you have to. If you have to, then you know you're going to have to atone for it. It's cool, bro. Like, we'll help you out. We'll try to testify you. If you do, use your word for good. And that's about it.